Welcome to another bonus edition of Upon Further Review.
Upon Further Review.
And in this edition, we'll be talking about the San Diego Chargers at the Buffalo Bills in this Week 3 matchup. That happens on September 21st at 1 p.m. Eastern Time, and you can catch that on your local CBS affiliates. So the Chargers are coming off a huge win as they beat the defending Super Bowl champions in San Diego. The Seahawks came in, and the Chargers put up huge numbers, real big numbers. Rivers and Gates connected for 3 touchdowns as they surprised a lot of people. Of course, in Week 1, they lost by just 1 point to Arizona, so they faced up against a couple of really tough defenses so far this year. And Buffalo, they beat Chicago in overtime in Week 1. And then they routed the Dolphins, who were coming off a big win against the Patriots, and that was in Buffalo. So they went into Chicago, beat them in overtime, then they beat Miami by 19 points in Buffalo. Now these two teams are facing off. What's going to happen? Of course, we have that high-powered San Diego offense going against that Buffalo Bills defense. I'll tell you right now, the Bills defense is underrated. They are far better than people give them credit for, especially up front. That front seven is one of the best front sevens out there, especially that line. They've got 2 all-pro tackles, defensive tackles right up front, so with Darius and Williams. And in this game, the Chargers are going to be without Ryan Matthews as he was injured, so it's going to be Danny Woodhead who's going to be getting the call. They also got Brown as well, because they'll be splitting time, but I wouldn't be surprised to see Woodhead get a lot of snaps. As we saw last year, Phillip Rivers likes to throw the ball to Danny Woodhead coming out of the backfield, because he got a lot of throws his way last year, especially late in games. It seemed in a 2-minute drill late in the fourth quarter, that's where Rivers would connect with Woodhead. So I wouldn't be surprised to see him get a lot of, touches and offensive plays in this game. Of course, he's not a very physical runner. He's a little guy. He's almost like the Wes Welker of running backs. But he can catch out of the backfield. The Chargers are going to have to really block well to protect Phillip Rivers in this game. Because if he gets under pressure, then that's when he makes mistakes, as we've seen in his career. Although Phillip Rivers has definitely matured into one of the top quarterbacks in the league. But it's on the other side, Buffalo with E.J. Manuel. He's just now in his second year, but he's looking pretty impressive so far as he's led the Buffalo Bills to the first place in the AFC East in this young season as they're 2-0. And going into Chicago, he didn't make any mistakes really. And he's only got 1 interception so far this season. Against the Dolphins, both games he protected the ball pretty well. They've got a 3-headed monster at running back between Spiller, Jackson, and Dixon. We saw Spiller had that huge game against Miami. He had that 102-yard kick return. If they can get some special team scoring in this game, that'll go a long way towards beating the Chargers. Of course, this is in Buffalo. Not going to be so cold, but it's going to be colder than San Diego. We know that those warm weather teams don't really travel well to cold environments. So you got to give some, an edge there to Buffalo. And then, even though San Diego, they went to Arizona and faced up against their defense, which was a little banged up even though the Cardinals still are one of the top defenses in the league, especially with their secondary and all around their defense. I would say that actually the Bills are probably closer to the Cardinals defensively, even though the Seahawks, yes, they're the Super Bowl champions, they're the top defense last year, it's the Legion of Boom. But we all know that there tends to be that Super Bowl slump that teams come off of. They did look really good in Week 1, the Seahawks, but then there in Week 2 on the road, seeing that they're not quite the juggernaut everyone thinks they are in terms of, they're not going to be undefeated as San Diego already has now proven. They're going to lose some games. If you want to actually look and compare like type of defenses, I think Buffalo is closer to Cardinals type of defense than they are towards the Seahawks. And that's going to be right there, you know, a recipe for success for Buffalo. They're very physical in the trenches. They're actually, I almost give them the edge over the Cardinals being that they're healthy. So if the Cardinals get shut down, the Chargers, the Bills should be able to do so as well. And they should actually take some of the things that worked in that game to put pressure on Phillip Rivers and to keep him from getting that passing game going. They can stop that. They get in there with that rush, especially that push right up the middle, like I said earlier, with Darius and Williams. And then they got Super Mario right next to him. He's coming around. They get some sacks. They get those pressures. Even if you don't get to him, if you can throw him off, make him, you know, feel the heat, then it's going to be a long day for San Diego. And without Ryan Matthews in the backfield, they're going to have to rely heavily on that pass. And if they can't get the ball off, then they're going to struggle to score. Of course, I would imagine the way I see it going is that Buffalo probably gets out to the early lead. Once they jump out to that early lead, San Diego's going to be playing catch-up. Phillip Rivers at that point probably put up some yards, but I see it coming down to the end where they're down by at least a touchdown, maybe more, and then trying to come back but falling short, and Buffalo wins. That's what I think is going to happen. Like I said, the Buffalo Bills are the type of team, they're old school, you know. They run the ball, they play defense. They've got a quarterback that doesn't turn it over, doesn't really make mistakes. And he also can scramble, too. So as long as E.J. Manning keeps doing what he's doing, that's the recipe for success. I mean, because the Spiller and Jackson in the backfield is also, you know, Dixon, too. That's three guys to hand it off to. And with, you know, Sammy Watkins had a big week in week two, if he can come out and put up some numbers like that in week three, Buffalo should be winning this game, and they should actually win it looking more like they did against the Dolphins than against the Bears, which they shut down the Bears' offense. They held them to just 20 points. And we saw, you know, what the Bears did against the Niners' defense and what Brandon Marshall did. So you gotta give a little more credit to Buffalo, the way that they were able to win that game in Chicago. You know, and like I said, the Chargers, that game was very impressive against Seattle. It was at home, though. And if this game was in San Diego, I might actually go the other way. You know, but it's in Buffalo. Being in Buffalo, it being so far north, all the way across country, the temperature and everything, the weather, even though this is September, it's not December, that'd be even worse for the Chargers, or better for the Bills. But still, it does have an effect. Without Ryan Matthews, and no real running game to speak of, and Gates is actually banged up, even though he was banged up going into that game and caught three touchdowns. So, I mean, you never know with guys. You see they were saying that Devin Hester was questionable going into the Thursday night game last night. And then he breaks history with his 20th special teams touchdown. So you can't necessarily pay attention to if a guy is questionable or probable. Because if he's playing and he's on the field, he's more than capable and plenty talented, as all the players are in the NFL. And these are the best of the best. Only the best players get to this level. So it's going to be a good game. And it could end up being a close game. I wouldn't really be shocked. Phillip Rivers with his arm can always keep the Chargers within striking distance. So it very well may come down to the end. Would not be surprised. But I think they got to try. If the Chargers, the only chance they have is to keep it within a touchdown. If they fall behind more than one score, then they won't be able to, you know, come back in the end. They'll end up falling short and lose by like 5 points or something. But if they can actually keep it within a touchdown, they'll have a chance. Personally, either way, I think the defense of Buffalo will be too much for San Diego. And even if it's an interesting game, which I hope it will be, I love watching exciting games. But in the end, it's going to be Buffalo, and they're going to shut down Phillip Rivers. They'll stop them, and they'll be able to hold them to low enough score to where the Buffalo Bills will be victorious in this game. That's what I think. I'm very interested to hear what all of you think, so let me know what you think by leaving a comment below, and I'll respond if you would like me to. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope you enjoy the show. Make sure to subscribe and like, and check out the channel, so we've got videos uploaded almost daily.